The typical West Side program, if you have one heavy day and one speed day, if you're doing, if you're trying to lose weight while maintaining your strength, if you do deadlifts and squats, or they call it the posterior chain and squats in one day, and you're heavy benching another day, make those 2 days your high days. So those days you're taking in extra nutrients, still creating the, especially if you train at night. If you train first thing in the morning, you might want to have the high day for the day before those days. But on those days, you're still creating the environment for growth, the leverage capabilities to increase your strength, and then on the other days, reduce your carbohydrates. If you're just trying to lose weight and you're more than 10% body fat, you don't have to be extremely precise. Just focus on eating healthy foods. Everyone knows what good foods is. Everyone knows chicken's better than pizza. I mean, for the most part, it's pretty obvious, and if people aren't following it, it's not because they don't know. I think most people here know that meat is a protein. You know, rice and potatoes are carbs. Take a complex carb, healthy fats like nuts, and good solid proteins. Lower the carbs on the other days, and on those two max effort days, load up the carbohydrates. Lots of carbs, especially around your workout, even simple sugars around your workouts. Maybe some fun things like sugar. Just make sure fat intake is very low on those days, and you'll still be able to progress in strength on your main effort days. You'll have glycogen to fuel your speed days, and you'll have lower levels of insulin most of the days of the week, higher levels of glucagon, which will create an environment where you can burn fat while you're getting stronger.